Hello traders, this is Petko Aleksandrov, and in this video I will share with you some more about the MetaTrader platform. What are the pros of using this platform, especially when we do algorithmic trading, and I will go through the most important that you need to know so you will feel comfortable when trading with the expert advisors. And of course, if you have already watched some of my other courses or you're familiar with algorithmic trading and MetaTrader, you can skip that lecture and go ahead with the course. But if this is the first time you are going to use MetaTrader, I would suggest you watch that video. So on the left side, we said that we have the market watch with the bid and the ask price. This is from where we can select the assets we want to trade. If you don't see all the assets, you can right click and check show all. This will display some more assets depending on the broker you're using. And if you want to open a new chart, you just click on the symbol and you go to chart window. So right here I have already opened two charts for the Bitcoin, and I have some more for Forex which were opened by default when I installed the MetaTrader. So let me remove those. And here I have one chart for Bitcoin on hourly time frame, and the other one I can change, for example, to M15 time frame. Okay, what are the time frames for the beginners? If I zoom, you will see that the chart is represented with bars, and we have actually three types of charts. We have bars, we have candlesticks, and we have line chart. The most popular is candlesticks. So when we are on M15, this means that one candlestick or one bar represents 15 minutes of a time. Okay, the chart is a representation of the price which we have on the right side and the time which we have below the chart. Okay, where these two meet, we have the candlesticks, we have the price. And if we are on hourly chart, then one candlestick or one bar represents 1 hour time frame. And for each candlestick, for each bar, we have the opening of the bar, we have the closing of the bar, the highest point and the lowest point. So in this case, the negative bar is represented with white color and the positive is with black color. Okay, so if I put the mouse on the closing of the bar, you can see exactly what are the values for the open, high, low and close. And what happens after the bar closes, a new bar opens. So here is the closing of that bar and then the new bar opens. The price goes up and down, it closes at one level. And because the closing was higher than the opening, we have a positive bar that is fulfilled with black. And all of these colors you can change from properties. And if you go to colors, you can change what you want to see on your chart. Now, I'm not touching that because when trading with expert advisors, it really doesn't matter what you see on the chart. It doesn't matter if you are on a candlestick chart, on a bar chart, what are the colors. We don't put any indicators, nothing over the chart, okay? I just wanted to give you a brief idea what we see on the chart as price, because at the end of the day, the price always matter, and that's the most important thing that is on the chart. But for trading and strategies and expert advisors, we use different indicators. So if I go to insert indicators and I click randomly on any of those, let's say I will select a trend indicator called Bollinger Bands, which is a very popular indicator in algorithmic trading, you will see three lines that are around the price. But I'm not going into indicators, I'm not going to explain any complicated stuff because you really don't need to know it. And I will go to indicators list and I will remove it. One more time, when trading with expert advisors or with robots, you don't need to place anything over the chart. The indicators, the trading rules, they will be inside the robots, and I will show you later on in the course what are the rules, how I create the strategies, how I test them. even before putting on a demo account. Alright, then on the left below the market watch we have the Navigator. This is where we have the accounts. As I said, you can have many accounts with a broker, but if you want to test expert advisors on different accounts, you need to install different platforms as well. Below we have the indicators, very similar if you want to insert them from indicators, or you will insert them from the Navigator. Just double click on it and it will be over the chart. For example, the accumulation indicator is displayed below the price, not over the chart. So let me remove it. And then we have some scripts that are useful for algorithmic trading and different purposes. But the most important is right here, expert advisors. And I have one expert advisor for the Bitcoin. And in the next lectures, I will show you how I'm creating robots, expert advisors, how I'm testing them, and how I'm installing them on the MetaTrader platform. Below the Navigator, we have the terminal where we see our balance or our account, the equity, and what is the margin. So basically, the margin is how much free money we have in the account, okay? How much we have blocked from the account and how much free margin we have in the account. So when we start opening positions, some of this amount will be blocked. And this depends on the leverage you're using. For example, in Europe, we have the ISMA regulation since 2018, and we cannot have leverage more than 2-to-1 for the cryptocurrencies, which means that if I want to buy a whole Bitcoin, I will need at least to have somewhere about $10,000, right? Depends what the price of the Bitcoin is at the moment, but the leverage for the beginners, with simple words, is the amount of money that the broker borrowed the trader to use for trading, okay? So if I have $5,000 in my account and I use leverage 2-to-1, then I will be able to buy maximum with $10,000. If I use leverage 100-to-1, then I will be able to buy 100 times more from what I have in the account. And of course, the leverage is very useful, but when you are using it carefully, okay? We don't buy with all of the money of the account, because if you use high leverage and you open position with all of the money, then it is very likely that you will blow your account. Of course, you can make very quick profits, but that probably will be more of a lucky trading, and at the same time, as I said, it is very likely that you will just lose everything in the account, okay? So take it easy with the leverage. It depends where you live and what type of broker you use, but it is always very important to trade small piece from your amount, so you're not risking the whole capital in a few trades. And this is how usually beginner traders lose their money in the first month of their trading. And in the next lectures, you will see that I'm trading many different robots with a very small piece from the account, or I'll be using actually 0.01 as a lot size, which is the minimum quantity that is allowed to be traded on the MetaTrader platform with Hot Forex. Alright guys, so this is about the MetaTrader platform. If you have any questions, let me know. Along the course, I will explain more details, but if you just play around with it, you will see that it is very, very easy to use, and especially for algorithmic trading, is just a few clicks to put the expert advisor on the chart and to make it start trading for you. All right, thank you for watching. I always wish it to you. Have a great day. And if you have found that video useful, don't forget to like it and subscribe to our crypto trading channel. Have a wonderful day. Bye.